Okay, here we're going to talk a little bit about similar triangles. You know you have similar triangles if all of the angles are congruent or equal. If all the angles are equal, then all the sides have to be in proportion. All right, so when I look at this first example here, we're given two triangles. You have the small triangle and the big triangle on the outside. So this small triangle is actually similar to the big triangle because all the angles are equal. Certainly you could see here they're both right triangles and they both share this angle right here. Okay, so right away you know that they both have a 90 degree angle. This angle is the same for both of those, the red one and the green one. And since these lines are parallel, we have these angles here are equal as well. Okay, so what we have here are congruent or similar triangles. And so I can set up ratios to solve for x, right? So the base of the small one is to the base of the big one. In other words, x minus 3 is to 2x minus 1 as the side of the little one is to the side of the big one. So as 2 is to 6, right? And so those sides are in proportion like that. And that's going to be our setup. Once we're there, we can just simply cross multiply, do the algebra, and solve for x. So 2 times 2x minus 1 has to equal 6 times x minus 3, right? Cross multiplying. And then 4x minus 2 distributing equals 6x minus 18. And then we'll go ahead and just get opposite side like terms. I'll subtract 6x on both sides. And so we have negative 2x minus 2 equals negative 18. Adding 2, negative 2x equals, is that going to be negative 16? Right? And then dividing by negative 2, we get x equals 8. Okay, and that was the goal, to solve for x. If it actually wanted the sides, we could plug that in, right? So this side, this missing side here would be x minus 3, so 8 minus 3, this side would have been a 5. And then 2 times 8 is 16 minus 1, this side would have been a 15. Okay? And just really quick, the ratio here, 2 over 6, is called the scale factor. Okay, so in other words, when I reduce, I get 1/3. So in other words, the smaller triangle is 1/3 the size of the bigger triangle. And it's this scale factor that gives trigonometry its power. Okay, we'll see later when we define right triangle trig, this becomes very important. Okay, let's do another one. Okay, so here we're given another sort of illustration where we have two parallel lines, and this will make two triangles. So again, we have a smaller triangle here. I'll highlight that in green. And we have a larger triangle. And these two triangles are similar because all of the angles are equal. So they share this angle. And then it was given that these angles were the same, and so therefore these angles have to be the same as well. So these things are definitely similar triangles, and so we can set up some proportions here. In this case, I'll do it a little differently. It doesn't really matter how you set up your proportions as long as you're consistent. Well, I'll do base to base. So I'll do 6 is to 10 as 5 is to. Now the length of this side of the big triangle, the red one, is actually 5 plus x. So that's a little tricky. This is just part of the side, the x. All right, so that's our setup. That's the proportion that we need to solve. And again, from there, to solve this, we just do the cross multiplication. So 5 times 10 is 50, and that's going to be equal to 6 times 5 plus x. Distributing, 50 equals 30 plus x, and then plus 6x. So a little bit of a mistake there. 50 equals 30 plus 6x. Sorry about that. And then subtracting 30, we get 20 equals 6x. And then dividing by 6, we get 20 over 6 equals x. Now just reducing, we have reduced by 2, we're going to get 10/3. 10/3 equals x. And that's what they wanted us to do. The instruction was to solve for x. Okay, so there you go. Similar triangles, we'll be using the power of similar triangles when we define right triangle trigonometry. We'll see you there.